Smart War Games here. Let's do a tutorial on manual torpedo solutions in John Tiller naval campaign games. For this, we will boot up Jutland and use the attack of the U9 scenario depicting the historical attack of a German World War I submarine. British will be AI with fog of war. Yeah, we will keep visible torpedoes and let's hit it. Yes, we are the U9. Let's take a look at it. Exactly, and we can already start the game. We are at periscope depth. Now you think, what the heck? Manual torpedo solutions in John Tiller games. Yes, it makes indeed sense. There's the most recent game of the naval campaign series GTS is Wolfpack, focusing on submarines and ASW escorts, which comes with a function that you can let the game calculate a fire solution for you. I can also show it to you in how it hypothetically would look like. However, currently the other games, meaning Jutland, to HEMA, Guadalcanal and Midway don't have this function. So you either need to launch torpedoes, no matter of which weapon system, be it submarines, be it destroyers, be it all other surface ships, be it aircraft, you need to launch torpedoes by either eye, or you can use some, let's say, low level calculations that shouldn't take that much time. Yeah, exactly, we will need the calculator for it. Ah, it's already open. Okay, yeah. And we will wait until we are in contact. And for this scenario, you can also load an overlay of the historical attack I found, which is quite interesting. Yes, it was a German submarine sinking three obsolete British armored cruisers. It wasn't really that important for the war effort, but it was a psychological propaganda victory, which let the British realize that the German submarines threat to be taken, not likely. And here, you see, we can continue. It is the yellow line is the U9 route, and where it torpedoed what. I mean, we can keep it like this, but for this tutorial, we'll disable it because it is cluttering. And the AI will not behave exactly like those ships there. Okay, let's speed up until we are in contact. Okay, we found the first ship. Yes, we will continue on our route. Need to watch out that we don't get too close, otherwise our periscope might be spotted. Let's continue simply. Now about torpedo solutions. First, to get a better view, more information, we'll activate the range grid. A range grid here, this is basically depicting one nautical mile. Some values for you to keep in mind. One nautical mile. One nautical mile is 2000 yards. Ship speeds are measured in knots. One knot is a nautical mile per hour. We will do basic calculations based on those three universal values: speed, distance, time. That's basically the bread and butter of every ballistic solution. And for this, we will get closer and I will show you an easy formula. However, you can also use sophisticated formulas. But the most difficult part, estimating the bearing and the speed the game basically handles it for you. You can assume that your crew is doing calculations and calculating the target speed and also the course. In reality, these data are really not that easy to acquire, and sure, if you play, I don't know, some hardcore realism, you could stop looking at it. However, of course, the interface is always showing you the truth. It is not like Dangerous Waters, where you might see, or Command as well, where you might see, at least to my knowledge, wrong data on the tactical display. To some extent, it is possible. For example, when hunting submarines, you might not see exact the positions. But in this case, right now, we see basically the true location of the armored cruiser. While in reality, it wouldn't be that easy to find out exactly in what direction this thing is going and exactly how fast it is. So we have already two very important values we can work with. And looks pretty good. Wait, I will simply... I mean, we can use this tool here. To find out how to use it. Yes, one limitation is that the game has a range ring system, which is quite helpful. The problem, however, is it is way too big for submarine operations. I will pause the game. It is basically like this. Would be quite helpful. It gives you the bearing and the distance in relation to what you're clicking. It is meant for bigger operations. You know, this game main course is surface warfare. So for submarine operations, which resolve in, yeah, let's say in few nautical miles or even yards range, it is way too big. So not that helpful. For us, we can basically deactivate it again. However, you could use it, of course. I have an on-screen ruler. It is not part of the game. Just trying to... Yes, I will show you where I got it. However, I don't recommend to use stuff like this. Simply get an old-school ruler. Best is transparent. Sure, watch out that you don't scratch your screen if you are sensitive to stuff like this. And measure it on your screen or whatever, but there are rulers you can get. The problem is most freeware rulers can't rotate, which is quite limiting. Okay, wait, let's start from the beginning, but yeah, it is working again. I just want to clear my... Okay, first things first, just for this tutorial to show you what I'm doing, I myself would do it simply with a real life ruler, steal it from your kit or whatever, I don't care, because for this solution I will show you, you don't need sophisticated instruments. Again, what I will show you is a really rough and quick calculation of a torpedo solution. Yeah, which also is trained to real commanders in order to calculate solutions fast, really fast, especially, you know, when targets are moving or zigzagging. There is no time and also no reason to do some complicated solutions, because every second the solution might become obsolete. And yeah, I found one single tool that allows me basically to go diagonally with distance measurements. And it is freeware, it is called MB Ruler. It is there's a free version. It is quite a sophisticated tool, most of the stuff you wouldn't need. And yeah, turn off all of this, for example, the magnifier you don't need, and I turned off some overlays and whatever. I just looking for this thing here, measure line, single line. Then you get something like a point ruler, and you can point it in all directions and measure it. It will provide you a number. You might think, what is this? And Yeah, it is pixels as far as I'm aware. And it of course depends on your zoom level and whatever, and you might think, yeah, that's not helpful. That's A, because screens have different pixel amounts. People play with different resolutions, so it's not that easy to find a standardized thing. Also, one more reason why it might be a good idea to use an on-screen ruler, but keep in mind, if you change the zoom level or whatever, this might become obsolete. Because you see, if, for example, I measured here, I wanted to know what is the amount of pixels a nautical mile has, somewhat 100 pixels, but if I zoom in, it changes again. So we will play from the closest zoom level, which also makes sense for submarine operations, and we will find out 1 nautical mile is represented by 200 pixels. That's it. That's only what I want to know, because I want to do stuff like this. Let's say this guy is he is moving into this direction. But you don't need this tool. Yeah, do it simply. Get some, like I said, on screen would be way more convenient, I think. That is a nautical mile. Okay. But right now we don't need it. So, yeah, we already have data about speed and direction. He is going north northeast. So we will go south southwest. And come towards him. And what can we already prepare while moving in the target? We need to calculate some data. For example, what is the speed? Normally, stuff like this is done by a torpedo computer. And from what I've heard, they also had it in World War I already to make it easier for them. And yeah, but the game provides you everything what you need. So, G6 torpedo we are carrying. That is basically our main weapon system, and you will check here database data and find out that the G6 is running with 27 knots. That's good, because now we can go into the calculator and simply to have it in our what was it again? 27, right? Yes. 27. So big. Okay. Pause the game so we don't we take our time. So we know the torpedo runs 27 knots. I previously mentioned 1 knot is 1 nautical mile per hour. So it's I also recommend to translate 1 hour into seconds. 1 hour is 3,600 seconds. And you can simply input 3,600 seconds and divide them by 27 knots. And you will know what? That this torpedo needs 133 seconds. We can perhaps get a file here open. Torp needs 133 seconds to pass 1 nautical mile. That's basically what we've currently found out. It's a good value to keep in mind, because if you do speed, distance, time calculations, everything behaves linear. So if one value is halved, yeah, let's say you halve the distance, the time also halves. You have the speed. The time it requires doubles. Yeah, and with this, that's what the submarine commanders train a lot of, often train, and you will become quite used to it, and then you can do quickly calculations in your head. There's a good thing where you, I don't know, look at the, it's called Perisher, it is the submarine course of the British modern submarines, how they train submarine commanders, and there, as you can see, they often are provided in stress situations and need to do a lot of calculations with changing speed or whatever, etc. So we know a torpedo requires 133 seconds to pass a nautical mile. Okay, what can we get next with this data? We know this the time. We also know our target is traveling with 9 knots. Now we can calculate first in you can to take simply the value of 1 nautical mile. For example, you can also input 9, but I will make it easy. Yeah? 1 nautical mile divided by 3600. That is basically, this value is very small, yeah, because that is now the amount of distance traveled in a second by something that is 1 knot fast. So first we will multiply it by 9 to reach the speed of the ship. This is the amount of distance traveled in a second, yeah, by something that is driving 9 knots. However, 1 second is not enough. We know the torpedo requires 133 seconds to reach 1 nautical mile. What distance will this ship cover during this 133 seconds? You can again multiply it by 133 seconds, and you get a value of 0.33. Let's remove the rest. 0.33 is a good number. It is 1/3. When you launch from 1 nautical mile on a ship, the ship will travel, when nothing changes, of 1/3 of a mile before impact. And keep in mind, this is only true when you calculate an impact point that is basically 90 degrees. So my plan is currently, I will show you, this ship will move by, and I want to hit it right here. Yeah? And when it is 1/3, I mean, we can take the ruler, let's say here, and what did we say, 200 pixels are 1 nautical mile, so 1/3 would be 66 pixels. Here, yeah, when the ship is here, I will launch my torpedo towards this point. When I'm a nautical mile away, this means I would be required to be somewhere roughly here. We can do it, why not? 1 nautical mile is quite a big distance for a torpedo attack. Looks small on the map, but in reality it was quite big. German submarines in World War II, they launched at, yeah, several hundred meters, whatever, but we can do it. We might launch a salvo of 2 torpedoes in order to make the chance bigger. And yeah, this on map linear, sure, if you move, this stuff happens, yeah, so watch out. If you move the map, because this lineal it would be great if you would have tools like this. This is really in all naval campaign games, at least some drawing tools. But it's roughly, yeah, it is a roughly solution. I'm not going here for pixel perfect. So we will venture towards this pixel here, this point here, and get in position there. And hope that the ship doesn't change the position meanwhile. Also we need to see that it is moving not exactly like it was. Yeah, so slow down and do it properly. Use the linear. You start simply here, point it on it, and allow it some time. You can also speed it up. And then simply always keep it on the ship, and you will find out quite fast the vector of it. If it is not moving, if it would be zigzagging, everything changes. But yeah, this looks proper. Let's pause so the stuff not goes too fast. Okay. Okay, could we get a second rule that I didn't try this out before the video? This doesn't look like. I guess it is possible, but I don't want to screw it up. But we can use a marker. A marker, in-game marker, to mark the position. So. Okay, we are close. We are basically 25% to close. What does this mean? You need to subtract from the distance that this one third, 25%. You could do it. I mean, sure, but I wanted to show an easy solution. Because the rest you will figure out yourself. I mean, it's basic mathematics. And yeah, we will simply drive in the circle. Because I want to stay at 200 nautical miles, but most of you will get the idea what I'm meaning. And yeah, 90 degrees. Just to make sure. And there are also some protractor tools online. I mean, you need to check it out. But yeah, perhaps if having something like a triangle ruler at home, you can do all of this stuff extremely quickly without doing this, what I'm doing here. I just want to show it to you. Because, for example, I now have the issue to calculate 90 degrees with this tool. I will do it with my eyes. Yeah, and 200 here. So this is our location we need to go. Speed up. Normally, it's not really realistic to slow down to zero for a submarine because it can cause issues with depth control, from as far as I know. But also for this, to make it easy, I would also launch from the half. It would be even better because you are closer. But we will do it anyways, and I will stop the submarine completely when in position. I mean, one knot is also a joke. You can, of course, run one knot, but yeah. Okay, we are in firing position. Yeah, I moved the thing. That's fine because I now will need it. Like I said, we want to fire when this thing is at 66. Just look, it will be somewhere here. Okay, we have some time, let's speed up. I will fire two torpedoes because we are using steam torpedoes. The enemy often see them from, I don't know, somewhat 1,000 yards away, especially in daylight, and will start to maneuver in this game to make sure that we ensure the kill. So I'll speed somewhat up. Okay, you should get me soon close to this point. Now I can go closer with this thing here. 66, we said. When this ship hits this green dot here, I will launch two torpedoes. Perhaps not exactly at the center. We'll launch one here and one here. Yeah, so no matter what he does, we should hit him. Okay, he is now at the firing location. Leave me alone. Let's fire one. Is there fire? I think so. So on this tool here. Yeah, I will move it to on the side so I get rid of this thing. Ah, yeah, I'm not pressing control. Yeah, sure. I'm not pressing control. Control is the fire button. Okay, now we go. One was planned here. And one will fire here. Okay, let's speed up. God damn it, yeah. But you see, the AI saw them quite fast. It was indeed somewhat 1,000 yards, but didn't manage to. But from the trajectory, you could say that it was quite a precise solution. And at night it works better. Speed up. At night it definitely works better. Let's say you can also set it for yourself. There's also a parameters tool where you can set the visibility of torpedoes. Somewhere here hidden. Yeah, but that's how you can do a calculation. And again, don't use those sophisticated. You don't need those sophisticated tools. Basically, a triangle ruler, a transparent one, would be completely sufficient to do really quickly calculations. And now I will show you, for example. You know, the situation often changes, the tactical situation, and we calculated he will move one third of a nautical mile in this situation. Now something happens and you end up at half of a mile firing distance. So you simply need to take also this distance divided by two. So the ship will move 1/6 of a nautical mile, and I don't know, the speed slow, the ship slows down to 4.5 knots. Again, and you can when you know about those three values and how they, and if you train it a bit and perhaps also use a calculator, you don't need to do it by head, you can quickly adjust your solution. However, this method is only really for those 90 degree shots. If, for example, now, we now in this situation, I mean, it would be not a good firing solution anyways, but a torpedo computer theoretically could calculate it. Yes, you could also calculate it on a map, would require a bit more stuff, and angles. It is possible to calculate firing solutions for this also by manually without even drawing lines. You call it, but it is not a good firing solution at all, because the surf target surface is really small. The hitting this target will be difficult. The enemy is alerted, might start sudden movements any second, and yeah. But U9 sank all three armored cruisers. They were going hilly-billy all over. He sank them all. You can go quite close. You can also go below 1,000 yards, fire the torpedoes. They need some range, I guess, to stabilize in the water. But you can go close, because also in order to counteract the distance, especially at daylight, when they see the torpedoes approaching. And yeah, and if there's no other choice, use salvos like I did here. If he would have gone for the perfect solution, he would survived. I guess, yes. Because he immediately turned 90 degrees right, presented us the smallest target surface possible. Because I already was knowing that he either will speed up, he will turn into the torpedo, turn away from the torpedo, two torpedoes for the possible evasive routes. Okay, that's it. It concludes this. Have fun.